This problem, we have a binary liquid with mole fraction of 0.3 for component 1. We're also given the pure component saturation pressure and the pure component saturation pressure for component 2, 40 degrees C, assuming an ideal liquid solution. And now it gives the chemical potentials of the pure components, so it's not in the mixture, the pure components. And the question is, what is the chemical potential of component 1 in the vapor phase that is in equilibrium with this liquid? So, liquid mole fractions and then the pure component saturation pressures are the important starting values, keep in mind, and ideal solution. So that means the fugacity of component 1 in the liquid phase is X1 times P1 set, right? This is just from Raoult's law, where the fugacities are equal, Raoult's law, Y1 times P. This is the fugacity in the liquid phase and in the vapor phase. And so fugacity in the liquid phase is 0.3 times 1.2, so 0.36 bar. So the question is, how do fugacities relate to chemical potentials? Originally, we defined fugacities because they were easier to use than chemical potentials, and the relationship chemical potential component 1 in liquid phase minus chemical potential component 1 as pure component. So this is the mixture value. Relation between these two chemical potentials is related to the fugacities by fugacity of component 1 in that liquid phase mixture over fugacity of pure component 1. And this is fugacity of component 1 in the liquid phase mixture is the mole fraction times the saturation pressure. Fugacity of the pure component, an ideal gas, the pressure is low, is the same as the saturation pressure. So we can see that this difference in chemical potentials is just related to the mole fraction. So chemical potential mixture, liquid phase, chemical potential pure component. And so we can calculate chemical potential liquid phase mixture as the pure component chemical potential plus this term that has the mole fraction. We're given this value, the gas constant, because this is joules per mole. So we're going to use gas constant joules per mole Kelvin, absolute temperature, and then the log of the liquid phase mole fraction. So chemical potential in the liquid phase is 4,500 minus 3,133, 1,367 joules per mole. Problem asks, what's the chemical potential in the vapor phase? Well, that's identical to the chemical potential in the liquid phase. I'll reduce the number of significant figures because at equilibrium for the mixture, chemical potentials must be the same in both phases.